Out now from Arrow Academy is a film I'd never heard of from 1988 entitled Life is a Long Quiet River. This, I went in totally blind on this. I had no idea what it was about. I just popped the disc in and let it wash over me, which is my preferred way to watch a movie, but probably the least likely way anybody else is gonna watch a movie. It's easier when they give them to you for free. This is a tale of two families who discover, one very rich and cultured and one very poor and kind of like comedic grifter type people, always looking to get a little something for free or scam somebody or steal something or fake a claim of something or something. These two families find out that they each have a child that was switched at birth. Something went on. They explain how it happened in the film, and each has a child that belongs to the other. So basically what happens, I'm not going to get too much into the plot, but basically what happens is the rich family wants their child back, and I don't want to say buys the child off the family. The kids are both like in their like maybe low teens, let's say. The rich family makes a financial arrangement with the poor family to reclaim the son that they didn't know they had or didn't know was theirs, and also retain the child who belongs to the poor family. The poor family doesn't really care about having another mouth to feed. They're just happy to get the money that the rich family is giving them. And it's very interesting. I didn't know going into this if it was going to be funny or not, and it is funny. It's pretty funny throughout. And you see this young boy who was, again, sort of in a family of grifters, adjust to having everything he could ever dream of, and, you know, be in this mansion and doing refined things and eating with the right fork and all this sort of things. And to a degree, he resists it, but he mostly embraces that. And still, you know, he worries about his family, and occasionally he goes back to see his family. And then slowly over time, you know, he starts to influence his friends and brothers and sisters in this new, you know, high society world with some of the ways of the street, so to speak. And comedic hilarity ensues. At the same time, the daughter, who was not taken back by her poor family, goes to visit them, and is sort of, there's a little drama in there. And it's one of those films that when you watch it, you think about, well, what would I do if I was in that situation? If you were one of the parents, how would you react to it? If you were one of the kids, if you were one of the siblings, it does make you think a little bit if you're a thoughtful type person. And yeah, for a film I'd never heard of, I quite enjoyed it. It is subtitled, but that's totally cool. It's well shot, looks great on this Arrow transfer. I don't know really that I would peg it as a movie from 1988 if I wasn't told that, just because a lot of the style isn't really evocative of the era, and it looks so good. There's not much in the way of extras. There's, I think, a 46-minute standard def featurette on this where they interview some of the cast and crew for the film. And it was a nice surprise. This is one of those, you know, people keep saying, what are your revelations or things you've discovered while in lockdown? And I have to say that I think Life is a Long Quiet River is one of those films that I'd never heard of, and I watched and I can say, wow, I can see why Arrow Academy would put this out. This is really good. And I wouldn't necessarily equate this with one of the greatest films I've ever seen, but this was a nice surprise and the kind of film that I think more people should see, and the kind of film that, you know, if the Alamo Drafthouse locally here was still open, this is the kind of film they would show to, you know, expose it to more people. So I must recommend, from Arrow Academy on Blu-ray, Life is a Long Quiet River.